Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we are exploring Obduction, and I've... Best intro ever. Hair stuck in my mouth and crap, making it hard to talk. Okay, anyway, we are back here at the garage, where I remembered this phone, and I remembered it back when we were looking at the rotary phone thing that was locked up. That had locked the elevator on the tower. And I thought about this, but I remember that this didn't do anything when we tried pressing all the buttons on it. But I came back to it, and I was looking at it in between this episode and the last. Obviously, you didn't see me looking at it at the start of this episode and thinking about it. And I did realize something, that since all of these numbers from 2 to 9... are labeled with letters, maybe that corresponds to the letters that were on the license plate. We got the North Carolina license plate that said NT6403. Now, 6403 obviously would be, you know, numbers to input in the code, but N and T, there's no way to put those numbers in on the rotary phone that locks the tower. But on here, N is on the 6, and T is on the 8. So maybe 6 and 8 is the number that we need to put into the thing to unlock the tower. That's what I'm thinking, and that's what I sincerely hope is the case. Also, just for anybody who happened to notice, I did drop the settings down again because of the horrible performance we were getting last time. I've basically turned off anti-aliasing entirely. I lowered the texture quality, and what else did I do? I lowered the water quality, and I think there's one other thing I lowered. I can't remember, but basically, everything is now at low, except for texture quality. It should still be at high, and which it was at epic before, and the foliage is still at medium, because foliage at low completely disappears. There isn't just less of it, it's just gone entirely. And the texture quality in my testing doesn't seem to actually affect performance all that much at all. So for now, we're gonna just keep those where they are, and yet the game is still gonna be stuttering and everything, because as unfortunate as it is to say, I really don't think this game is very well designed in the performance department, which really sucks to say. Like, I love the first two Myst games. I have a lot of confidence in Cyan to develop good, a good game. You know, they can develop good puzzles, they can design a good world and a good story and everything like that. But I guess this is kind of the first, like, really modern game that they've made. Like, Myst 5 came out in, like, 2000-something, early 2000s, I think. And I don't know how well that game performed, but by now, if I were to go back and play Myst 5, just because it's so old, even if it wasn't very well, even if the game wasn't very well optimized for its time, by now it certainly would run at a high frame rate. Ow! Oh, I'm sorry, I tried to move in my chair and I just kicked my desk and it made so much noise. Unpleasant. Yeah, by now it would, you know, run fine, but this is a modern game that they've made this year that I'm playing, in the same year it came out, with a modern computer that is able to play other games of similar visual quality with much higher frame rates. I can play Witcher 3 on this computer with a constant 60, you know, frames per second, and that's with most of the settings on, you know, high or even max, and only a few of the, like, post-processing effects turned down. So it's just, it's really unfortunate. But anyway, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 8, Then 6403. 6403. There you go. That's what I thought. Oh, that makes a little phone noise. That's cute. Thank you, elevator. Oh, and it's a fast-moving elevator, too. Good job. Alright. And this will take us right down here to where the mayor lives. That'll take us down below the tree. But let's check out the top first. Because I think top would not be progression. So let's check this out first. Because it's more fun to not progress, you know? Oh, geez. I spoke too soon. This thing, oh god. Oh, that looks terrifying. Hey, look! It's like a modern flat-screen TV. Right next to a really old TV. There's a view of the tree and the town and everything else. Big view of the mountains. Holy crap. Those look so pretty. Alright. Ugh, ugh. See, frame rate again. Like, geez, Jesus Christ. Really good view from up here. Really impressive place. Oh, can we see the... Oh, we can see that there's no water going over there. Sort of, maybe. I don't know. The rocks might actually be covering it. Hmm. Very pretty. Very good. Okay, so Mofang, Kaptar, Marae, and Hunrath. Uh-oh, the Mofang one's been broken. And they're all on zero. Okay, and all of them except for Mofang look like pressure gauges. Mofang's just a digital... Mofang is just a digital display. The others are pressure gauges. And we can't actually interact with this at all. Oh, that's surprising. That's very, very surprising. I thought this looked like a puzzle we were going to have to figure out. Looks like it's completely stationary, though. At least for the time being. Sure, once we go down, it'll probably light up. Hmm. Cool. Alright. Alright, now let's go down below the tree. Fucking chair is falling again. Why has it got to do this? Why, oh why? Alright, can we go down anymore? Just checking. Oh my god, we can. Oh, wait a minute. Actually, we were still in the mayor's office. Okay. Whoopsie, I thought we had already gone down below. Now can we go down anymore? No, we cannot. Okay. Oh, that's nice of them to put a little carpet out for us. Huh. Okay. Alright. There's a... Ooh. Toilet. Thingy for playing music. Can we interact with this at all? Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay. Cool. Yeah, it's just playing music. Doesn't seem to really do much else. That's unfortunate. Oh well. Alright, now let's read this note here. Worksheet, multipurpose Valaine control panel interface. This is the control panel that Valaines have supplied for our use, blah blah blah. Valaine numbering systems base 4. Yeah, this is the same thing as before. Oh, but it's partially filled in. Okay. That's probably important. So I'm gonna write that down real quick. Valaine numbers Valaine numbers 1, 5, 18 and 158. Those are the ones that are filled in. So those would presumably be the ones that are important. Okay. So, keep that in mind, I guess. No, okay, nothing else to do with that, it would seem. Alright, let's go up the stairs. There you go, good old hand crank. This is what we saw from before when we were above it. Awesome. Lower the door. Now we can get into the tree. Alright. In that case, let's go up. And let me... Oh my god, this is the worst chair ever. I need to buy a new chair. Thing keeps, like, fucking lowering itself down. Amazing. Okay, so... Oh boy. Oh, we couldn't see that from before. No, sir, we could not. Okay, well, the water's already going down into it. We already did that much, so... I trust we were supposed to do that. Oh, this is so cool. This isn't a normal tree. Not by any means. I mean, we already knew that. They did... They mentioned how the tree basically gave the whole town life. With the seeds and everything, but... Still, they know. Jeez, oh, this looks so cool. To be honest, this kind of looks like Cthulhu or somebody who's part of his party could be hidden down there. Oh, I'm stuttering again. Oh boy, oh jeez, oh no, no. Please, game, please. Please stop. Okay, let's get down here. Is that actually magma? It looks like magma. And holy crap. Holy crap. Oh my god, it's the rift. It's literally the... Oh, this is... Whoa, this is something else. So... It's bigger on the inside than it is on the outside. Oh boy. Okay, where does this go? Assuming we can't go through this at all. Yeah, this is making the same sound as the barrier around Hunrath did when we stepped into it before the red laser was deactivated. I have a feeling this is probably at some point going to connect. Well, actually, this is the heart, actually. CW said this is the heart of the tree. And when I looked at that diagram of the different planets, it made it look as if the heart was a different planet. Maybe the heart is just a central location that is in each of the three planets. And at some point, these things are going to connect to a, like, teleporter between all of them. That would be awesome. That would be so amazing. Okay. And yeah, one more. Okay, so we got a yellow pipe going to that one, green pipe going to that one, and blue pipe going to that one. That's how we'll remember them. Alright, and these are the roots. CW said we had to do something with the roots, I think. Oh man, this looks awesome though, and that music! Oh, and the red cord, the red pipe, goes up to Hunrath. So these are three other completely different areas. I just assumed one of them was Hunrath, because I didn't really realize yet, but no, that makes sense. There's four cords here. Four cords for four different worlds. Can't interact with this at all, so it seems just this lever. Thank you. not lava at all. It's water. Holy crap. So it filled up with water, and the water is just a different color for some reason down here. I guess there's something under the water creating that light. And it filled up until it overfilled, and it went down all these. And it's filling the roots and everything. The pressure gauge thing has risen slightly. It's up to, like... yeah, it's going up very slowly. Still going up. Hasn't reached the max yet. Okay. Doesn't seem to be anything we can do with the cords. And none of those, presumably, portal things seem to have changed. Still going up. Okay. I don't think we want to touch the lever again. Alright, let's go back up. Because there doesn't seem to be much else to do down here. Let's go back up through... oh my god, the most, like, beautiful caves ever. Uh-oh. Game suddenly stopped us and it has to save. We ran too fast. We literally can't move until it's done saving. And I presume it's... or assume... probably be a more accurate word. I assume it's also loading something? Probably loading in the next area. Maybe I shouldn't have run up here. Oh geez, this is gonna take a while. This is a weird thing to happen. It's never done this before. Like, I mean, it's taken long to load before, sure, but it's never started saving and loading at the same time. Which I presume is what's happening. I mean, I can't imagine why it would make our character stop moving to save the game. And especially without, like, no transition screen or anything like that. Like, when we activated the teleporter things... yeah, now we can move. It just finished saving and now we can move. I presume it was also loading, but that's so weird. That's what the who does that? Well, there has to be some kind of transition scene. You can't just show the symbol for saving the game and then make the character unable to move and be like, oh, there you go. That counts. That's a loading screen. Alright, well, obviously this thing likes what it's getting because it's glowing all over the place and the leaves have changed to green, where they were previously red. So that's good. So now, let's go back to CW, and frickin' hopefully the frame rate will fix itself along the way. Let's go back to CW and see if he has anything else to say, because we've now gotten the roots all hooked up, I presume. There doesn't seem to be anything else we can do, so I'm gonna have to guess there's nothing else we have to do. And we did hook up his battery, so... hopefully he's happy with that. Hopefully. Come on, buddy.
It's nice not having to do all this myself. You just keep connecting all the trees, all the roots. I gotta finish the plates around the tree and get them connected to my battery. I ain't already done so. I need that battery cable plugged in. Remember, everything connected.
Okay, I think I already did it though, buddy. Pretty sure. Let me go double check. Because this has to be what he's talking about. It's got the notes next to it that, you know, call it the battery, and talking about their battery testings and everything like that. So this has to be it. This big thing has got to be the battery. And also, if this thing's connected to the tree... wait a minute, why have the leaves changed colors again? It was green when we were under there. All the leaves were green. Now they changed to orange. Maybe they were red because they weren't getting the water, and then we gave them the water and it changed green. But then it sort of like, I don't know, maybe it steadied out and went to golden yellowish. So yeah, this thing is, there's nothing else to do here. There's just this one cord doohickey. Let's try fucking it up. Unplug it, plug it back in. Maybe we just need to do that again to get him to recognize that we did it or something. I'm gonna guess so. Let's go back and talk to him again. Then let's check out the tree again. Wait, fuck, we passed him. I'm an idiot. Sorry. Oops. Of course he'll get mad again, because he's gonna, oh, I don't have time to waste on you without your horse sense crap and stuff. Blah.
Pardon me, but you've got trees and other worlds. Roots to connect. Connect that cable on the side of the battery if you ain't yet. Go on now.
Okay, buddy, calm down there. Whoa. Sheesh. So yeah, okay, so I guess we're done with Hunrath. Sort of. But that doesn't seem right. Let's go over here and look at this door again. Let's see if there's something we missed. Because we still never got onto the other side of this door. And I refuse to believe that such a simple looking door that's just across the river could be something that's being saved for the end game. Like, come on. Come on. Come on. Alright, fine. Screw you. Little button in the middle here that isn't actually a button, it just looks like a button. That's stupid too, you stupid door. Alright, so yeah, the only thing that leaves me confused is the fact that we still haven't gone through that door, or been, in general, been able to get to the other side of the river. And we also still have not gone inside the other statue, the bleeder. Which, conversely, means we also have not been able to get up to the other side of the waterfall there. And there's also that building right there, that doorway that's above where CW is, and that's all completely blocked off because we can't get past the tile things that are on those train carts, and we can't get back up to the waterfall or anything like that. We also were never able to go across this thing because this like track here that leads over to that. Wait a minute. This changed. This has so changed. Dude, game, stop freezing. This was not pointing this way. This was pointing the opposite direction before. Get up here and maybe get a better look at it. And where the hell did that thing come from? Seriously, what the hell? Let's go back up there real quick. Get a closer look at it, I think. Because that makes no friggin' sense at all. And also, the leaves are green again when we're down here. When we're looking up at the tree, the leaves are green. Maybe that's just a visual glitch of some kind. Maybe the leaves are supposed to look green, but for some reason when you look at it at a different angle, maybe it's a glitch with the lighting system of the game or something that makes them look gold and before red. And yeah, this is just like straight up broken off too. It's not even like there's... Yeah, I don't remember that thing being there, that tower with the sonar panel looking thing pointing at the tree. And that was pointing in the opposite direction before. I'm pretty sure it was pointing that way and, like, hanging down above the tree. So I don't know how those changed, unless I'm just an idiot and completely forgetting. I don't know. We still can't interact with this, even though it looks like something we should be able to interact with. Alright, fine. Let's go down to another area then. Let's go to the jungle one, because that's a bit closer. It makes sense, at least in the case of the bleeder tower thing, because they talked about that thing potentially being able to, like, remove the barriers or whatever. So it makes sense that we'd come back to Hunrath after completing all the other areas, and then, once we've done that, we'd be able to somehow access the bleeder, and... I went the wrong way, didn't I? Shit. Let me go back this way. Yeah, it makes sense that at that point in the game, we'd come back to Hunrath and do something with the Bleeder Tower, but there's still the other areas that we haven't really touched on at all. And that leaves me confused. Also, these are super green from under this side. Completely, totally super green. Oh well, alright. Let's go back this way then. Back through here. And which way was it? This way. Over here to the button. That should lead us to the jungle place, which I guess is Murray. Or maybe the other one could be Murray, the place that looked like Riven. Either of them could. I don't know. No clue. And then, I don't know. I guess we'll just have to remember what's here in Hunrath. Oh, for the love of God. Please, frame rate, please. Yeah, I guess we'll just have to remember the stuff that's here in Hunrath that we haven't done yet. And so, if somehow the other worlds end up allowing us access to, like, the Across the River area or whatever, then maybe that could, prove useful once we come back, but I highly doubt it, to be honest. Alright. Also, that loaded a lot faster this time. I can't help but think that's probably due to me putting the settings way down. Don't know. Alright, that's not a direction we can walk in. Neither is this. Okay, cool. Oh, but look, there's another sphere of something right there. Alright, cool. Let's go down here. To be honest, I really think the other area looked cooler. Like, jungles are sweet. But that other place, the cliffs and everything... Wait, it looks like it's straight out of Riven. Way more to my style, personally. But this is the first one we found, and I think this is obviously the more or less out of the way one to get to, so I have a feeling we're intended to go here first, which means the puzzles will probably be easier. I say right before coming up to a locked door with no way around it. Oops. This looks like Valaine stuff. This looks like very similar to the little robot that's in the garage that you use the Valaine. Oh, hey! That's cool. A little map right there that we can sort of get a sneak peek of. But it doesn't tell us much. But yeah, the design of this technology looks similar to the robot. And especially that one, too. That one there is like a... is the spitting image of what we saw in the garage. So I'm guessing this is the Valaine's home planet, or at least, I mean, a section of it, a spherical section. For some reason, is this just a dead end? Can we not do anything here yet? That's a little weird, actually. Huh. Well, all right. Can't walk over there, even though we totally should be able to. Yep, can't get up there. All right. Can't climb up the rocks, of course. So what the hell do we do with this? Nothing to even click on. Very, very weird. Huh. Other side. Even though I've already really done this, honestly, but just double checking, I guess. Okay, so there's a door here that we can't get past. There's no other pathways that I can see. So we're kind of screwed out of going to this place. Doesn't seem to be an option right now. I guess we'll have to come back. Alright, fine. Guess we'll have to go to the other place first, the Riven-looking place. And that is fine by me. I do not mind one bit. Mm-mm-mm. I mean, honestly, like, I feel like I'm missing something. I pressed the button already, damn it. I feel like I am missing something. I mean, there's gotta be something else you can interact with there. Because the thing is, so far in this game, everything that we could interact with, we could interact with right from the beginning of the game. The only thing stopping us from, like, progressing, like, anytime we came up against a locked door, the only thing stopping us from progressing is because we didn't know the right code, or we didn't know what to do, or where to go, or whatever like that. And from what I played of Myst and Riven, it's the same deal with those games. You can beat, quote-unquote, beat Myst in, like, 30 seconds. You start on the dock, you go around, you flip the levers, you do the thing with the fireplace and everything else, and there's some other stuff to do. I don't want to, like, spoil it, I guess, for anybody who wants to play the game themselves, but there's some stuff that you can do right from the beginning of the game, as soon as you start it up, and within, like, a minute, you see the end cutscene of the game, and you completely skip even going to the other, going to the other ages, and Riven was the same, basically. You know, the only thing stopping you from progressing in any of these games is that you don't know, it's faster to go this way, is that you don't know what to do. Once you know what to do, you can just skip through all of the, you know, technically optional stuff, the puzzles and trials and things that are just there to fill in context and give you clues and answers to other puzzles, and you can just do the essential ones in order to go straight to the ending as fast as possible. So that's what confuses me about that place with the jungle thing, is because it didn't look like there was anything to interact with. It wasn't that we came up to a door with a puzzle that we didn't know the solution to because we needed to go somewhere else first to learn the solution. It's that there was literally nothing we could interact with, and that's what confuses me. So that means I must have missed something, or maybe Obduction is different from the rest of their games in that regard. And if it is, if that's really what they've gone with, then I have to say that's pretty disappointing. Okay, so apparently at some point when we had just loaded into Hunrath after returning from the jungle place trying to get past that stupid door, the game, or not the game, I'm sorry, my recording software stopped recording the video of the game. So I'm going to end up leaving the black screen in with what I was talking about, because what I was talking about was relevant to the game, but we'll cut ahead to here, where I've now gotten to the other area, which hopefully will actually allow us to progress. As we can see, there's a lever here to interact with. As I mentioned in the last thing, the weird door over at the other place was very puzzling to me, because it didn't seem to have anything we could interact with. And, well, what the hell is the point of a, you know, new area if you can't even get in there? So we've come to this one instead. So this place, okay, seems to be a pretty simple bridge set up here. Pull that, and that would probably, I imagine, turn the bridge to come here if we somehow had ended up at this side when the bridge was turned. But I'm betting that this will do nothing. Okay, cool. So first, we probably have to turn this wheel. Oh. Why is that spinning? There you go. I figure that's what we need to do. So who's the jerk that built this bridge so that it didn't just connect that spot to that spot, and instead you have to get on the bridge and turn it? Like, seriously. Come on, guy. Alright, it will not move anymore. Can we move it further to the left past its initial spot? Obviously that wouldn't seem to serve much purpose, but just checking, because if we can, then that means it might serve a purpose that we can't yet see. Okay. It's interesting. I wonder how that works. It seems to be, I don't know. There isn't enough up there for the wind to be blowing it, and I also can't imagine that there's much wind blowing in a, you know, singular dome like this. But yeah, it's I don't know, but okay. Well, hey, look at that. We got to the other side. First puzzle down. Congratulations, this place is already more interesting than the jungle place, because it looks cooler and actually has stuff to do besides a blank door with nothing. So hey, we'll come back and we'll do this, more of it, when we come back next time, and I hope you've all enjoyed it. I'll see you all later. Bye-bye.